This $2,500 MRI scanner from Prenuvo could save your life, and I believe it's the future of healthcare as we know it. So today, we're gonna go explore how it can help us live healthier and longer lives.
So we are a full body MRI scan. It's going to look at everything from top of your head to your ankles and look for 500 different conditions, including cancer, things like aneurysms, fatty liver disease. It'll look at your spine. And so what we really like to say is that it gives you a really great baseline of where you're at with your health. You know, we know what's going on outside of our bodies. We don't have that picture of what's going on in our bodies, right? And so the best thing to compare yourself to is yourself. So this will give you that baseline. And then, you know, when you come back in 12, 18 or 24 months, you're able to compare where you're at today to then.
Not gonna lie, honestly, I was pretty nervous because I had no idea what to expect. And I was really worried about if I was going to realize that maybe I had cancer or maybe I had a massive problem that I didn't know about. But anyways, you get in there, you change. You gotta take off all the metal on your body because basically an MRI, I didn't know what it was, but it's essentially a massive magnetic field and it uses radio waves as well to essentially get detailed images of your body.
Have you ever had an MRI before?
I think so. I've had CAT scans and other things too, so.
So if you're unsure, I just want you to be aware that they're very noisy.
Okay, okay.
It sounds like a construction site in here, but you
okay.
Have headphones and hearing protection, okay?
Okay.
All right, you can come on in.
This is actually a full body scan. It takes around 45 minutes to an hour, but at least on the good side, I got to watch Netflix. Essentially the way it works is you wear these goggles that have a mirror on it. So the TV is actually playing behind you and you can watch whatever you want. Seeing these scans afterwards is absolutely wild to think that the amount of accuracy that they're able to see of my body, there's my brain, my spine, it just absolutely blows my mind.
Oh my God, like not moving for such a long time was wild. In the beginning, I was super itchy. I kind of took it as like a meditation mindfulness thing. I'm like, okay, cool. I'm just gonna watch Chef's Table. Hopefully this goes away. Luckily it did. It got pretty hot at the end, but like you had a button that you could press if like you had needs to stop it or anything, there was emergency. So it was very stiff coming out and it was like way freaking louder than you could ever possibly imagine.
And now that the scan's done, I just have to wait until my results are ready and then I'll be able to see them all online. And I'm gonna have a call scheduled with a professional that will walk me through the entire thing so that I can understand what the heck's going on.
So you had a good scan overall. There's nothing concerning because nobody ever has a clean scan. There's always something. So head to toe, starting off with your brain was totally normal and your liver was normal size. You didn't have fatty liver. That's the most common thing we see.
Yeah, we don't want fatty liver disease. It like cascades to all these various things.
And a lot of people that we do see it in, it's because of their diet and extra weight.
Yeah.
And to save you some time, there's a bunch of other things that we went over in the report that were all good to go as well.
And then the spine section. We always have findings.
Yeah, I'm expecting something there.
You had mild scoliosis.
Yeah, I was expecting scoliosis in like the more so this part of the spine.
You have a disc herniation in your lower back. This is the last level of your lumbar spine. This is right above your tailbone. So herniated means that the substance within the disc has come out a little bit. So it appears to be a small disc herniation because if it was a large one, then it would be causing like narrowing of your spinal canal. And have you been having pain?
No.
I mean, majority of us do not have any pain with herniations a lot of the time, but some people can. So after the age of like 30 or so, or mid 20s, early 30s, we'll start to see changes in the discs, like in the neck and the lower back. So you just have this one level. As long as you're not having frequent pain, there's nothing required for it. They usually heal over time. And even if you were having pain, they usually treat it with like physical therapy.
Yeah, probably should put a bit of emphasis there then, or just generally on spine work. That would be a good idea. Well, I'm glad to hear everything's good. I'm glad you didn't come on and be like, your body is broken.
I know.
Dying.
It better not be. You're only 25, so.
We got years for that, I guess.
So I would say I really had three main takeaways from doing this experience. The first one really underscores what I love to preach and I think is extremely important, that what gets measured gets managed. I think about it in terms of inputs and outputs. The inputs are, did you hit your calories, your protein? Did you get good sleep? Did you do your exercises? But on an outputs wise, also being able to understand, hey, are my MRIs getting better over time? Do I have cancer? Is my spine getting more messed up at a faster rate? Various things like this that I can actually start to quantify and see. It's the same thing as getting blood work done. These are just more outputs that I can essentially look at, objective measures that I can essentially track and see over a period of time. Also, this really reminds me of approaching my health from an offensive perspective rather than a defensive perspective. So much of the things that we do nowadays is really waiting until we have a problem and then allocating our resources to go and solve that. This is a really good opportunity to actually see, hey, what are maybe some things that I'm gonna struggle with in the future? So for example, I might have really bad lower back pain as my herniated disc maybe gets worse. Hopefully it gets better, but that's something I can actually see, and now I can start doing spinal work, etc., trying to strengthen that area because I barely do any lower back exercises, and there's probably a reason that I messed up that area, and now I have an opportunity for growth. I can be offensive. And number three, I had no idea this even existed. Now I know this is a new tool in the toolkit, and it's something I can use on top of the current stack that I'm using to continue to make sure that I'm going in the right direction over time. If you'd like to try this out for yourself, Prenuvo is actually giving you guys a discount code that you can check out in the description. And also, I understand this is really expensive, so if you can't afford it, that's completely okay. At the end of the day, doing the fundamentals over a long period of time is gonna get you great results. There's always gonna be shit that comes up, and you'll deal with it when it happens. Anyways, I hope this was helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.